Hi, I'm Mariah Carey. Mariah Carey. Millions of records sold, tons of awards won, and a one-of-a-kind seven-octave voice. And now Mariah's back with the Remixes, a double disc gift to her fans featuring the best of her groundbreaking collaborations.
My fans wanted a remix album for like 5 years, so we're putting one out.
But how did she get here?
I don't know.
It's time to find out as we take you on the wild musical ride that is Mariah's career, from her humble beginnings.
We all kind of had mattresses on the floor and waitress.
To her explosion onto the scene.
She was showing it off. She was flaunting it.
To the ups and downs of life in the spotlight.
I wanted to keep up the success level, and finally my body was just like, good night.
This is Mariah, the complete history.
Let's go.
Carey's one of the most successful recording artists of all time. One big reason, she isn't afraid to experiment with her sound. Mariah's worked with everyone from P. Diddy to Boyz II Men to Whitney Houston to Old Dirty Bastard, mixing R&B and pop with hip-hop and house in groundbreaking collaborations and setting trends for future divas.
Guess who's driving the 500 like yippee-yi, yippee-yo, yay.
And her latest album, The Remixes, showcases just that, giving us the biggest and the best of her remixed work.
I've wanted to put out a remix album for like 5 years, and I think it's a really good collection. It's like a timeless type thing.
But long before Mariah became the remix queen, she spent most of her youth, like a lot of kids from her generation, as a child of divorce with her mother, Patricia, an opera singer and vocal coach.
I think that Mariah was a born singer, but the training certainly helped her with her range and her technique.
By the time she hit her mid-teens, Mariah was already splitting the day pretty unevenly between school and her true love, music. Someday, hey, hey, hey. She started to hit recording studios to work on a demo of her material.
I was working with my writing partner at the time, Ben Margulies, when I was in 11th grade. And I would drive into Manhattan from Long Island, and I would work till like 3 in the morning. I would drive home and try to get up on time for school. I was like more social in school than I was a student. I had trouble getting up in the morning, that's why. I couldn't take getting the first period on time. I moved into Manhattan like the day after I graduated high school with a couple of friends, and we all kind of had mattresses on the floor and waitress. I live with this girl, and she introduced me to a lot of different musicians. So they were working with Brenda K. Starr, and they heard me sing, and they said, why don't you come for the audition?
I just heard her sing, and I was like, wow, it was a beautiful sound, so I hired her.
She brought me to this party one night, and Tommy Mottola was there.
I went up to him, and I said, listen to this tape. It's like a tape of who? And I was like, this is Mariah. She wants to get a deal.
Then he left, and he put the tape on in the car, and he turned around, and he came back, but I was gone. So he finally found me, like, that Monday, and they said, you know, they wanted to give me a deal. Treated me kind,
sweet destiny. In 1988, Columbia Records signed the budding starlet to a deal, hoping Mariah would be their answer to Whitney Houston, Madonna, and Janet Jackson. 2 years later, Vision of Love, the first single off Carey's upcoming debut album, was finally released.
I got some really incredible responses from Vision of Love, from people that I didn't know, saying things like, wow, you know, I was really down, and this song changed my life, and I was just like, that's pretty amazing. Right through the night. We actually did two videos for Vision of Love. The first one was thrown out because the director had me like in a bra on a bed, and certain people thought that that was the wrong thing for me to be doing. I realized I could have and should have taken more control, but I didn't know. What the hell did I know?
This is Mariah Carey. Give it up.
Treated me kind, sweet destiny.
Being on that show, you know, it was kind of bizarre because I was just like, aren't I just the kid that was just at home watching this show? I was really nervous because that show was so huge at the time, and it was a big moment for me.
I thought the Tonight Show was definitely going to get this book. I was at the Ivy one night, and Tommy Mottola came up and he gave me this tape, and he said, see the girl sitting at the table with me. This girl is a cross of everything great in R&B. And if you heard her, it would blow you away. He promised me that if I liked it, he would break it on my show. And it was a hell of a night.
And it was all that you've given to me.
That was a very hip show at that time. It was at the peak of its popularity. And the way Arsenio set her up, there was a real sense of, listen to this woman. You're going to be hearing a lot of her.
I never sung in front of that many people, and I was really nervous. And when I watch it now, it's like this incredible feeling because I went up to the high note at the middle of From Sea to Shining Sea. And the whole crowd really, really responded to it, and nobody knew who I was at all. And like when I watched the responses of the basketball players, that was a special time for me.
The Palace now has a queen, and the goosebumps will continue.
That same month, with a pair of powerful live performances in her back pocket, Mariah's debut album exploded onto the scene.
Treated me kind, sweet destiny. Carried me through desperation to the one that was waiting for me. It took so long.
I want to thank VH1 and all you viewers so much for helping to make my very first video from my very first single, Vision of Love, the number one video for VH1 in 1990.
I had a vision of love.
And the Grammy goes to Mariah Carey!
To be that young and to be on stage singing with people that you have looked up to your entire life in the audience that night. All I know is I was intimidated as hell.
By April of 1991, Mariah had scored her fourth straight number one single, had won numerous awards, including two Grammys, and sold over 5 million copies of her debut album. Not too shabby for a former waitress from Long Island.